Good evening. Now I'm going to discuss about the salient features of Indian Constitution. See, there are so many salient features of Indian Constitution that I'm going to discuss some of the salient features of Constitution. First, Indian Constitution is having both rigid and flexible features. Why Indian Constitution is having rigid? Why it is rigid means the special procedures. Special procedures are needed for amending our constitution. Why Indian Constitution is a flexible form? Why it is flexible? See, for the same reason, in the some of the areas in our constitution, can able to amend by ordinary procedures. See, our Indian Constitution is needed a special procedure for amending the constitution. That is the reason it was rigid. And at the same time, some areas in our constitution are only needed ordinary processes. By ordinary procedure also, some of the areas of the constitution can able to be amended. That was the reason it was flexible. Second feature is federal system. India is a federal system. It is having the federal system. So the division of powers between the center and state. Divide the powers between the center and the state. In our constitution they mentioned the name federal. Though India is a federal country, it also has the unitary features. Then third one, parliamentary form of government. Parliamentary form of government. See, this parliamentary form of government we took from Britain. The government is responsible. The government will be responsible for the parliament. The council of ministers headed by the prime minister is completely responsible for Lok Sabha. He is responsible for Lok Sabha. Fundamental rights. The fourth one is about fundamental rights. These are the promotion of political democracy. See, in our original constitution, there are 7 fundamental rights. Present in our constitution, there are only 6 fundamental rights. By 44 Constitutional Amendment Act, they reduced 1, so it became 6 fundamental rights now. They deleted 1 fundamental right, that is right to property. This was deleted by the 44 Constitutional Amendment Act. They deleted 1 fundamental right, that is right to property. See, fundamental rights, if the violation of the fundamental rights has occurred, the person can able to directly go to the Supreme Court. It says in Article 32. which is a constitutional remedy. By the act, by the article 226, it says that the person can able to go to directly high court if the violation of fundamental rights, if the fundamental rights are violated, the person can able to directly go to the high court. By it says in the article 226, the person directly can go to the Supreme Court if the violation of fundamental rights occur only. He can directly go to the Supreme Court. It says in the article 32. Then directive principles of state policy, DPSP. Directive principles of state policy. We cannot challenge in any law, any. We cannot challenge this directive principles of state policy. Why? Because these are only guidelines for the aims and objectives of government. So, if the directive principles of state policy are followed or not followed, so we should not challenge in any law, any court of law. Then, fundamental duties. In our original constitution, fundamental duties. These fundamental duties added through the 42nd constitutional amendment by the recommendations of Swaran Singh Committee. By the recommendations of Swaran Singh Committee, fundamental duties are added in our constitution by 42nd constitutional amendment. That time only 10 fundamental duties were added. 11th fundamental duty were added in the year 2002 by the 86th Constitutional Amendment Act. 86th Constitutional Amendment Act, they added the 11th fundamental duty. India is having the feature of secular state. Secular state. See, in India, by our constitution, in India, equal respect to all religions. The constitution does not uphold any of the religion as the official religion of a country. So it does not uphold, it doesn't give any position for any religion. So equal respect to all religions. That is the reason it was having the feature of secular state. Universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise. So, the adults are permitted for voting up above the 21 years. Adults are permitted for voting. By the 61st constitutional amendment, they reduced the age from 21 to 18 years. So after the 61st constitutional amendment act, 18 years is the voting age. Emergency provisions. Emergency provisions. See, India will behave like a federal country. In emergency situations, India behave like a unitary form of government. And it is having emergencies like national emergency, financial emergency, and statement emergency or president rule. During these all emergencies, India behaved like a unitary form of government. Last one, three-tier government system. Three-tier government system, after the 73 and 74 Constitutional Amendment Acts, the Panchayati Raj and municipalities are also become the constitutional bodies. By that, by those two, it became the three-tier government. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel.